we're going to begin with a baby dedication for little Kellen Xavier Shetler. So if Kellen's here, could he bring mom and dad and family and friends and come to the front? And we never get tired of dedicating babies to the Lord. Tons of churches don't even have babies to dedicate these days. My wife Dixie will be joining me in a moment, and Gail, right, who heads up the ministries for our preschool kids. Here they come. Come right down in here. Let's spread around on each side. Just kind of gather around real close and arc around here, okay? So you can get real close and have a good view. Don't be shy. Come on right in. Getting adults to line up. Closer than that. I mean, all the way in here. Okay, they're feeling kind of lonely. Somebody want to get a little closer on this side? Why don't you guys move around here this side, okay? It's our privilege to bring little Kellen to the Lord in Christian dedication. This isn't a good luck charm. It's a serious, intentional act that he will never remember, but you will, and we will. Hi. She feels bad because I didn't say hi to her. Hi, big sister. Good to see you. But you will, and you will, and you will, and you will. And how I think of dedications is when I read the Old Testament and I read about great acts of God. And when God did something powerful in a miraculous way, they often erected altars or heaps of stones as memorials to God. So that children too young to remember and children having not yet been born would see that stack of stones, the altar, and they'd say, "Daddy, Abba, what's that about?" And they said, "I'm glad you asked. Let me tell you the story." And so I hope that the things that we give you, the little booklet, the certificate, and the rose, the little bud symbolizing innocence and purity, I hope that it'll be that way, that sometime you'll have a chance out of a scrapbook to sit little Kellen down and tell him about a time when you stood before the Lord in this congregation and you said, "Kellen, the Lord gave you to us. We're responsible, but you've come from the Lord." And we publicly said and declared that. And so in saying that, I remind you that the best thing you can do for him is to love God and to love each other. That never gets old. Grown adults that I deal with, that they tell me the strength of that in their life or the lack of it. So the best gift you can give is to love him and to love each other. And I always pray that a child will never come between that relationship, because a lot of times, though he's a gift from God, we can take the gift and run, but God has to be greater. As we love him more, he gives us the wisdom and guidance to instruct him and raise him in the way that he should go. And what I say to mom and dad, I say to all of you, a great heritage to have Christian family. And I guarantee you that all kinds of prayers have already been heaped up on him and over him. And those aren't just temporary prayers that go away in time, but they're stored up, and at the right time throughout his life, they're poured out. So keep it up and sacrifice and inconvenience yourself, his family and friends, to be a part of his life. We're too much all over the place in America. When we can make sacrifices to be there, do it. Because nothing can take the place of precious times that you sow into his life. And you're all important. So my prayer is that he'll see in your life a love for God and a love for your spouse and a love for one another. So mom and dad, if you'll just do your best before God, then that's all he asks. Because he's the linchpin, not us. Do our best by allowing him to work. Will you do your best to say, Lord, we're going to do it your way, and we want to raise him up in the way that he should go? If so, would you answer, we will? And family and friends, for the influence, will you honor God in that way and give of your time, of yourselves in any way to add to his life? If so, would you answer, we will? And congregation, we've said this many times, and we don't take it lightly. I'm reminded, even through some events this last week, of how important a church family is in the lives of children. If we'll do our best to make it easy for little kids like Kellen to fall in love with Jesus and him specifically, would you please answer? We will. All right. Come here, buddy. All right. Hi. Hi. Ah, yeah. He said that feels like a grandpa's arms there. Hi. All right, honey, I'll have you come close. We use a little rosebud that's yet to bloom and blossom and be all that it's created to be, but the innocence, the purity, and the possibility and potential is here. And so we come symbolically to remind all of us that he belongs to God, a gift from him, and we give him back. So it's my privilege as your pastor, Kellen, even as you yawn like many people in the congregation when I speak, I dedicate you to the one who made you, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I'm going to pray, and then Gail will come and add a blessing. Father, I thank you for this precious, precious life. We dedicate him to you, which means we recognize that he's a gift from you. And when we think of miracles, we can't think of anything greater than a little baby, a precious life, fearfully and wonderfully made. What a gift, what a treasure. I pray your blessing and protection upon him all the days of his life. I pray for your protection physically, emotionally, and spiritually. Give his parents discernment as they offer guidance. And may he be the rose, and may he bloom according to your plan and purposes that you've created him to be. So we thank you for this precious gift and the optimism and hope that we have because of you. I pray in Jesus' name. Yeah.
Lord, thank you for this child. Thank you for sharing in this family's joy on the day that he was born. And thank you for surrounding him with people who love you. And they will make it a priority to point his life to you, Jesus. Bless Kellen with abundant love that comes from you. And may he know your love and experience your perfect love throughout his life. May he be filled so richly that love would spill out from him like a fountain. May Kellen trust your love with confidence so that he will walk in his life in peace and rest, in the confidence in you, Lord. Bless Kellen to be a man of honesty and integrity, set apart for your service. Bless him with a special place of influence in this world, and empower him with a holy boldness to share your gospel of truth and not be ashamed. May he choose to have a relationship with you early in his life, and may he be mighty in your kingdom. Amen, Jesus.
Right. Okay, Dixie, little kissy here. Let's get a good view here. Where are we? Yeah. Can we get a good close-up here? It's little Kellen. you. Hi, everybody. Is he there? All right. Could we congratulate this family once again? Good work. Thanks for letting me do this. It's a privilege.
Thank you.
While pastor's greeting them, we've been trying to get this little guy introduced to you as well. This is Micah John Mead. This is Sean and Heather Mead and their newest little addition. Can we get a close-up of him, get him up there? We want to congratulate them as well on his new birth.
All right. That's a part of our worship. Because we're just giving him back to God, right? Recognizing God's creative wonder. So as we enter into now worship, the aspect of worship where we're going to be singing, I just want to remind you that we're not entertaining anybody except the Lord. And by entertaining, I don't mean performing, but I mean we're entertaining his presence, right? So as we get in, let's just be mindful. We talk a lot of times in staff meetings that sometimes we forget that a lot of movement in and out at key times of the services that can really be distracting for a lot of people in the grandstands. And by the way, we always have many guests, and a lot of times our guests are sitting up there. And just know that as we have quiet times, let's just do our best to refrain from movement. I know we're not elementary school, but I just think we need to remember that sometimes because it can be so distracting. So as we enter into worship and as at times of invitation and prayer, let's just keep movement to a minimum. And just make it easier for people to focus on the Lord. Okay? Yeah, you're hearing my heart on that? That's all. We're just trying to assist and not get in the way of what the Lord wants to do. I remind you that as we move through this service today, that the altars are always open. For those of you that are new, these altars are just a wonderful time, a place to pray anytime. And a lot of times this morning, we expect to have an invitation at the end of the service. And a lot of times you'll see people coming forward and using the altars. It could be during a song that's touching their heart. They could be overflowing with praise. They may want to move forward. That's fine. You don't have to, but you can. They're there to use anytime you feel like you need to. If you're really struggling with something, you need to unload that today. I can't think. Take care of business. The sooner the better, okay? And the more that we use the altar, the more that newer folk will feel like it's comfortable. And, you know, who knows what God will do in a time like this, huh? How he can just touch a heart in a moment. He can do more in this hour then we could get help from others in a lifetime, right? And so we welcome you, Holy Spirit, today. We want to be sensitive to you and your word and your way. I pray that hearts would melt in your presence, whether we understand it all or not, that we would be drawn to you and to your loving embrace. Some come today carrying great burdens and heartache. May they choose to cast their cares upon you, knowing that you truly do care for them. It is your love, it is your goodness, it is your presence in our lives that satisfies. Nothing else could satisfy us but you. May there be a hunger stirred in the heart and life of each one. So this is your time, we're your people, and may everything that happens during this gathering honor and glorify you. May guests feel the warmth of your embrace and the love of Jesus even extended through our sincerity. Thank you for this day that you've made. We honor you and bless your name. I pray it all in the wonderful name of Jesus. Amen. As we sing, you feel free to move about. You feel free to stand or sit or bow, whatever you feel like you need to do. But let's let our hearts be attentive, okay? Our hearts first. And then let's be obedient to the Lord.
right here in your presence. I worship you, my King, right here in your
Thank you.
You may give or take away, but you are all we need. You are all we need. You're all we
Show me your glory. Thank you.
So many words, all of them heard a thousand times before. Trying to say things far beyond what my mind can know. So why would I waste one more breath saying things that can't be said, as if I could reach your glory with my words? So I'll just be speechless. Thank you. in the moments you take my breath away. How can I find a thing to say about a beauty I cannot describe? I'll just be speechless.
Thank you for your love, O Lord. our world is reeling and rocking and chaotic. Governments are rising and falling, but you are in control. It is your love, it is your goodness, it is your faithfulness. We draw near to you. Lord, I thank you that you're extending your love to each and everyone in this room today, whether they recognize it or not. Your stubborn love, your persistent love. Your love is here filling this room today. It's compelling, it's convicting, overwhelming. It's your love that has the power to change this world, and your love alone. So we look to you. Our hope is in you. Our help is in you. Our strength is in you. Place of prayer, this is a place of healing, place of hope. It's Romans 8 that said, I am convinced, 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 convinced that nothing can ever separate us from God's love. Amen? Neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither our fears for today nor our worries about tomorrow, not even the powers of hell can separate us from God's love. No power in the sky above or in the earth below, indeed nothing in all creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus our Lord. And that's my prayer today for this congregation as your pastor, that the love of the Lord Jesus will be revealed in a precious way. I just feel like there's a lot more of you that would like to pray. I've been reminded in this past week multiple times that God's love is working and drawing and moving, often in ways we can't see, in circumstances that we think are out of control. God's love is in control. And no matter where you are today, that He is reaching out with His love for you in the middle of your pain, uncertainty, misunderstanding, whatever it is. And His arms are open. He's calling you by name. And He's saying, come to me. For some of you, He's saying, return to me. Return to me. And He's saying to us all, I want you to abide. I want you to live in my love. I want you to trust my love. I want you to surrender to my love, even in times that you can't make any sense of. And I have a feeling that there are some of you that just need to come and pray about that today. And we're going to continue to sing quietly. And the ushers, we're going to worship the Lord during this time. They're going to come. That's fine. That's not a distraction. But I just feel an urgency for some to surrender to His love. Even do it in a way where you mark it by walking this aisle, just to bow before Him. I don't know all the details. because it's through the very thing that you're going through that God is actually growing you and strengthening you. You feel like you can't go on. You feel like this is the end. It's not the end. You'll look back and you'll see that God is growing you, strengthening you for the task ahead, even by the season that you're in. And I'm asking that his love will be revealed to you in a way that only you can understand. But I feel in my heart that there's just oodles of people here that need to surrender to love. I don't know the specifics. But I want you to sing, continue quietly. And I feel like there's a lot of people that would just need this opportunity to pray. You can do it where you are, for sure. Some come as individuals. Others could come as families, couples. It matters not. But just to get a new, fresh glimpse of his love today. Father, may every heart be obedient. May every heart be obedient to you, to respond to you, say yes. I'm just going to invite a lot of you just to come and fill the front, the stairs, the floor here, the altar. I don't know where you are, but my heart's been feeling this before we got here today. I trust you, Lord. I'm going to drive it. I'm going to make a marker. I'm going to heap a bunch of stones. I'm going to trust you where I cannot see. Others just need to say, I'm going to surrender specifically to the love of the Lord in this time. In this, I don't know what your circumstance is. Others need to say, Lord, my heart's open. May your love invade my life. Come on. Come on. I think the Lord's changing directions today, and he's just saying, come on. This is the time. I'm stirring the water. Step in. Step in. Step in. There's plenty of room. Use the floors. Use the areas. You can circle up. Surrender to the Lord's love. Surrender something specific to his love. Don't know what you're going through exactly. He's more than enough. There's plenty of room. You can bow at the front rows. There's plenty of room on the sides. Lord, could you reveal through your Spirit in ways we can't understand specifically what you want to talk to us about and deal with us about? Oh, I ask for conviction. Conviction that nothing can separate us from the love of God. Nothing. And may that love dominate the landscape of our life and transform us. The power of your love, something we cannot control, we can only surrender to, respond to. Would you come? I think there's more of you. You may be new. It's not about attending church here. Just come on. Come to the front. If you need help with prayer, raise your hand and people of prayer will come to you where you are. That's fine. This is how we're going to finish the service today. There's time to pray. What is it that he's calling you to bring to him? What is it that he wants to touch with his love? What's holding you back? What's holding you back? What's holding you back? Choir, feel free to move out and respond if you need to as well. Band, anytime. Tech people, God's calling you. Surrender to my love.
How could I forget his love?
How could I forget his love?
How could I forget?
I'm asking you to think about his love, to focus on his great love today.
He satisfies.
And to act on it.
He satisfies.
Come on, are there others? I think there's this many more who would really like to spend some time in prayer. Just come. I know you can where you are. There's just something about stepping out.
Great is the measure of our Father's love.
Great is the measure of my Father's love.
So great is the measure of our Father's love.
So great is the measure of our Father's love. There's plenty of room for you. Some couples may want to come. Families may want to come together. There's just been some things that have been blocking that love flow. You need to take care of it. Not asking you to redouble your efforts to be good enough, right enough. I'm asking you to surrender to his love right now. It's not about something, it's about him.
So great is the measure of our Father's love.
That's what I'm asking you to return to his love over and over again. It's his love. Return to his love. Return to his love. Return. Return. Return to his love.
So great is the measure.
To every heart, could this be a day when everyone responds to your small, still voice, calling, beckoning, bring it to Jesus, come to Jesus, come to me, you're not too far, you can't outrun my love, I'm waiting on you, my love's pursuing you. Great is the measure of our Father's love.
So great, so great.
Unending love, unending love.
Great is the measure.
Great is the measure.
Great is the measure of our Father's love.
So
great is the measure of our Father's love. Great is the measure of our Father's love.
Sing a little bit sometime. It is your love, it is your goodness. It's your presence in my life that satisfies. So great is your love. So great is your love. How about it in the grandstand? Is God's Spirit drawing you? I know it's a long walk. Something happens when we just make a simple act of obedience and coming to pray.
It is your love. It is
surrender to His love.
It is your prayer,
a specific situation, an individual,
that fills
a worry,
me
a
up
fear.
Inside. It is your grace,
it is your grace,
your tender mercy,
your tender mercy.
It is your presence,
your presence
in my life that satisfies.
Just sing it to Him.
It is your goodness. It is your kindness and
passion
such compassion that fill me up inside. It is your grace.
If you're kneeling here and you need someone to assist you in prayer, just hold your hand up. Just keep it up and someone will come to you. We don't want to invade your privacy.
Satisfied. Nothing in this world.
This prayer time's our benediction, our ending today. We've got plenty of time.
Jesus, you alone can fix
us.
I could gain the world and all it. those things could never be enough. Cause it is your love.
Sing it to him.
It is your love, Lord. It is your goodness. It is your kindness and compassion that fill me up inside. It is your grace, your tender mercy. It is your presence in my life that satisfies your grace. It is your grace.
Sing it out to me.
Presence in my life that satisfies.
Presence in my life.
It is your presence in my life that satisfies.
We look to you, Lord. You're our source of strength.
There's no one like you.
There's healing in your presence, Lord. There's healing in your life.
No one like you.
That's what I'm declaring by my act of obedience today and even coming to pray. There's no one like you, no one like your love. There is nothing like you.
No one like you.
No one like you.
No one like you.
No one like you in all the earth. There's no one like you.
No one like you.
No one like you, Lord.
No one like you.
Not that we loved him, but he loved us. He loved us. He loves us. Whatever he wants you to do. I'm not saying that I know what it looks like today. When you need to go, that's fine. We're going to end service, but we're going to continue to worship softly and pray. And God's still wooing you with his love. He's courting you with his love and grace. He's calling. He's drawing you. Would you respond to it? Lord, may your grace and love continue to embrace us and engulf us and pursue us. May we truly recognize the power of this verse. Nothing, 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 nothing separates us. Continue to meet needs, answer prayer, touch and lift hearts and burdens around this front today, around these altars and these seats today. And may there be others still who feel you drawing them. May they yet respond. May they respond to your gentle call to come. Thank you for the sweetness of your presence. Thank you. We're not going to end this service. We're just going to let it flow as long as it goes. Again, worship quietly. You can move as loud as you need to, as you wish. Don't change the channel. Keep focused.
Understand it. I want to be obedient to what he wants to do. Your love goes first.